Hello, 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 everybody. My name is Steve Ford. Welcome to Test Preparation 30. Today, I'm going to be giving you some tips, some precious pieces of gold so that you can boost your score on the TOEFL or IELTS. So let's go. The first thing is that if there is a text and then a lecture, you want to make sure that you take notes from the text as well. I know that you only have 45 seconds and it's difficult to take notes, but even a few words can help you remember what was said in the text. The question may ask for information not only from the listening, but also from the text. So you could divide the subtopics into columns like this. You could also do it into categories like this, kind of like a point method, or you could do a visual representation which would apply to this lecture, something where you're drawing diagrams that represent something. Regardless of which kind of notes you take, you want to make sure that you're learning how to use abbreviations. I can't stress the importance enough. You need to take abbreviations because you don't have time to write down full words. My second tip is that remember the maximum score for each question on the TOEFL speaking is 4. What is a 4? A 4 is not speaking like a native speaker. A 4 is not a textbook answer that you will often hear in some of the TOEFL preparation books. So hopefully that takes a little bit of the pressure off. You will see if you go into these TOEFL books or even on your own TOEFL score that if they can understand what you're saying, even though you have an accent, but if they can understand what you're saying, even if there are some mistakes with your word choice or grammar, you can still score 4, a maximum score. Now, that doesn't mean that you can relax and just put your feet up on the desk and not worry about this, but it's to tell you that you don't need to speak like a native speaker who is prepared for the TOEFL to get 4. Another important tip is that you want to, if you have the time, if you have the patience, do what I'm going to do now. You want to go into the audio script. You want to skim through, look through to see if there are any words that you are not familiar with. Usually there will be 3, 4, or 5 words that you don't know, depending on the topic. In the following topic, you're going to be listening to a lecture from a business class, and they're going to be talking about organizational charts inside a business, inside a company. And there are some words that a lot of people would not know, which can represent a modern run business. And that's the parts of a wheel. Yes, do you remember when you were a child, or maybe you still ride a bicycle? And the part of the wheel, there's the rim, the spokes, and the hub. Those words will become important as you listen to the lecture, so try to keep those words in mind. Other words, we have the pronunciation of pyramid, another structure that's going to be talked about, pyramid, and also chaos. Maybe you have that word in your language. In English, we say K, like okay, and then os, chaos. Okay, so now that I've given you those tips, let's take a listen to a lecture in a business class. Regardless of how big a business is, we can find out each employee's position in the overall hierarchy of the company by referring to its organizational chart. Given that this information is available to all employees, these charts make it easier for them to communicate with one another. A more formal structure still used by some companies is laid out in the shape of a pyramid. In the traditional pyramid scheme, the whole structure is supported by the labor force, the bottom. In the middle, there are various layers of management all the way up to the top. The orders flow down from management while information flows up. This is a typical chain of command where each employee knows his or her place. Problems with the pyramid include making decisions which take a long time going up and down the chain of command. The entire structure, especially the managers, can become too inflexible, causing the company structure to stagnate. However, if there was no chain of command, there would be chaos. Thankfully, there are some companies using an organizational chart in the shape of a wheel. The labor force is the rim, management is the hub, and the departments are the spokes. There is a free flow of information from the spokes to the hub. Communication is much more open compared to the pyramid scheme. Staff are allowed to go and ask questions to any fellow employee, regardless of their department or position. An employee can send any ideas for company improvement in writing directly to the company president's office. Describe two kinds of organizational charts using examples and points from the lecture and what they show about a company. So, as you can see in my notes, there's one other one that I forgot to mention, which was chain of command. Chain of command. Who's in charge? And then who's in charge? Who's in charge? Yeah, it shows a hierarchy. That was another word. Yes, hierarchy. So we have the syllable stress on high. Hierarchy. All those words, hierarchy, chaos. Try to remember the pronunciation of those words. Pyramid. And you can see with my notes and the visual representation here, how I did it. I did it more visually. It was easier for me to remember. And then I was able to write down notes accordingly, abbreviations. And let's take a listen to this student's second attempt, where you can see that he was able to organize his notes better.
The two organizational charts are the pyramid and the wheel. The first one explain how the chain of command works. There is the support area, the management area, and the head of the company, which basically is a pyramid. But it has some disadvantages. For example, stagnation and time-consuming in decision-making. While the other wheel chart provides a better performance in terms of management, where basically is the hub, and then the departments, which represent the strobes, and the last but not the least, the rim, which represents the low force, and the information flows faster, and the people can talk directly with the other departments and works better in contrast to the pyramid.
Overall, in the second attempt, the student would get a 2.75 or a 3 out of 4. Okay, everybody, I hope that these tips were useful for you to improve how you can score on the TOEFL, on the speaking section, or the IELTS academic. I know that it's a very daunting task. Daunting means it seems a little overwhelming, like it's too much. But if you can follow these systematic tips, you will find that especially the note-taking will get you far. And I look forward to our next English lesson. If you would like to contact me, you can do that at the link below. And if you'd like to subscribe to my channel, you can do that here. If you would like to watch more videos, you can do that here. And I look forward to seeing you in our next English lesson. Bye for now, everybody.